championship today, 55-51. Update on Gamecock baseball. Carolina still leading Longwood 6-4. That game's in the top of the fourth inning, but Longwood threatening again. They got runners at second and third with two outs. Gamecock softball still trailing Texas A&M on the road in game three of that series as well. 2-0 there, so we'll see how that goes. Let's run through the starting lineups for you. First for the LSU Tigers, since they are the visitors here on the scoreboard, under third-year head coach Kim Mulkey, coming in at 28-4, finished second in the SEC in the regular season after going 13-3 in conference play. Mentioned they're a little bit banged up. Last year, Poa will not play today after the head injury yesterday. And so they'll get a freshman in there making her first career start. But at one guard, number four is Flajay Johnson, 5'10 sophomore from Savannah, Georgia, out of Sprayberry High School, where she was a McDonald's High School All-American, earned second-team All-SEC honors this year after being named the SEC Freshman of the Year a year ago. And she is not disappointed in her second season. She has been off and running in this tournament and throughout the season. She's averaging 14.2 points, 5.5 rebounds per game, and was eighth in the SEC during the regular season with just over two steals per contest. Another guard, number 11, Haley Van Lith, 5'9 graduate student from Wenatchee, Washington, former McDonald's High School All-American, spent 3 years at Louisville in her first year at LSU, averaging 12.2 points, 2.3 rebounds, 3.7 assists per game. Has over 1,800 points in her career, at 13 points against the Gamecocks in South Carolina's win in Baton Rouge earlier this year. Had another guard making her first career start, the freshman number 20, Janae Kent, 6'1 freshman out of Oak Forest, Illinois, out of Oak Forest High School, averaging less than 2 points per contest. She's in there with the injury to last year, Poa. Had a forward, number 24, Anissa Morrow, the 6'1 junior from Chicago, in her first season at LSU after 2 years at DePaul. Earned first team All-SEC honors this year, sixth in the SEC in scoring with 16.4 points per game, fifth in the conference with 10 rebounds per contest, is also fourth in the league in steals and 10th in blocked shots. And in the middle, of course, the SEC Player of the Year, who has led the SEC in scoring and rebounding in each of the last two seasons. It's Angel Reese, the 6'3 junior from Baltimore, Maryland, transferred from Maryland a couple of years ago, second year at LSU, averaging 19.1 points, 13.1 rebounds, leads the SEC, has 15 20-point games this season and 21 double-doubles. She had 15 points in the loss to the Gamecocks in Baton Rouge earlier this year. The Tigers in the road purple uniforms, gold numbers and trim. They'll be moving from right to left, or white numbers with gold trim, I should say. They'll be moving from right to left as we look at them from across the official scorers table here at Bon Secours Wellness Arena. For Coach John Staley's Gamecocks, coming in at 31-0, 16-0 in the SEC to claim their eighth SEC regular season title. Under seven-time SEC Coach of the Year, Dawn Staley, and it's the more usual lineup once again. Point guard number 25, Raven Johnson, 5'8", redshirt sophomore from Atlanta, out of Westlake High School, where she was a McDonald's All-American. Earned second-team All-SEC honors this year. 8.1 points, 5.4 rebounds. Ranked third in the SEC during the regular season. Has 4.9 assists per contest. Another guard, number 0, Tina Powell, 5'9", senior from Oceanside, California, out of La Jolla Country Day, where she was a McDonald's High School All-American, spent 3 years at Oregon in her first year with the Gamecocks, earned second-team All-SEC honors this year, averaging 11.1 points, 2.7 rebounds, 3.7 assists, ranks 10th in the SEC, leads the SEC in three-point shooting, but she's been held in check in this tournament. See if we can get her going here today. Third guard in the lineup, number 23, Breezy Hall, 6 foot junior from Dayton, Ohio, out of Wayne High School, where she's a McDonald's All-American, 9.7 points, 3.2 rebounds. And a forward, number 21, Chloe Kitts, 6'2 sophomore from Oviedo, Florida, averaging 9.3 points, 6.1 rebounds per contest. And in the middle, the hero from last night, the center, number 10, Camila Cardoso, the 6'7 senior from Brazil, former McDonald's High School All-American, named first team All-SEC and Defensive Player of the Year this year. 14.2 points per game, sixth in the SEC in rebounding with 9.6 rebounds, leads the SEC in block shots per game. Gamecocks in the traditional home white uniforms today, garnet numbers trimmed in black, garnet and black trim down the side of the uniform. They'll be moving from left to right. Your officials for today's game, Polani Spurlock-Welsh, Angelica Suffren, and Kevin Pethtel. We've had all of them many times this season. Sellout crowd here at Bon Secours Wellness Arena. They're on their feet from the start of this one. Gamecocks in search of their eighth SEC tournament title in the last 10 years, making their ninth SEC tournament title appearance during that span. Remember, they lost 2 years ago here on a shot at the buzzer by Kentucky to interrupt that string. Updating Gamecock baseball, Longwood has tied the game at 6 in the bottom of the fourth inning. And that game at Founders Park got a wild one going there on your Sunday afternoon. Gamecock baseball tied at 6 as they are in the bottom of the fourth inning there. Gamecock softball still trailing 2-0 in the top of the fifth at Texas A&M. Gamecocks break their huddle, their home whites. It'll be Camilla Cardoso in the jump circle, and she'll be opposed by the SEC Player of the Year, Angel Reese. Gamecocks won 15 in a row against the Tigers, including a come-from-behind 76-70 victory in Baton Rouge back on January 25th. They're racing an 11-point deficit. Chloe Kipp led the Gamecocks with 14 points in that one. Lead official to the jump circle, and we'll light this candle. TV's ready to go. Let's play some basketball. SEC Tournament Championship on the line here in Greenville, South Carolina. Ball in the air. Tip is controlled by LSU. Moving right to left as Haley Van Lift will bring it across. Working right side to Janae Kent, making her first start. Feeds it inside all by herself. Anissa Morrow, goodness, she blew past Chloe Kitts and had an uncontested layup, and that's not the start you want. You give one of the best players on the floor an uncontested layup. Gamecock somehow lost her defensively. Morrow had a good game against us the first time. Pow Pow at the free throw line. Feeds Chloe Kitts, and she just dribbled it off her own sneaker and out of bounds. Goodness. Bad start for the Gamecocks. Tough start for Chloe Kitts, who gave up a layup to her opposition and then dribbled the ball off her own shoe. So LSU will have it, leading 2-0 here early. Gamecocks had trouble with turnovers in the first game of this tournament, at 24 of them. Blaise Johnson across the timeline. She has been tremendous in this tournament, a pair of 20-point games in the first two contests for LSU. Passes left to Morrow, working on Kitts. Handoff now, Kent driving into the lane against Pow Pow. Floats it high off the glass, no good, and she walked with it. So both teams turn it over here, and the Gamecocks will have it, trailing 2-0. This will be their second possession. Raven Johnson will bring it up. Gets it across along the far sideline. Man-to-man defense for LSU. Here's Breezy Hall up top. Minute gone by. Pass it right side. Tina Pow-Pow. She'll launch a three. Off the rim, no good. Fight for the rebound. And Van Lith pulls it away from Chloe Kitts. Pow-Pow had a good look. Couldn't knock it down. She has struggled. She is 3 out of 19 from the floor in this tournament. Here comes Angel Reese. Drives in the lane. Floats it up. No good. Good defense by Cardoso. Rebound Kitts, and the Gamecocks have it. In transition, Cardoso running the floor. She will lay it up and in. Camilla Cardoso will start the scoring for the Gamecocks. And we're tied at 2 with 8:32 to play in the opening quarter. Here comes LSU. Lob it inside, ball knocked free by Pow Pow, and the Gamecocks come out of there with it. Here comes Breezy Hall quickly down the floor. Passes left to Raven Johnson. Raven, top of the circle, will settle into the half court. Dribbling right, hands it off to Pow Pow. Shot clock at 15 as we run our weave. Breezy Hall in the lane. Stops, pops, and drops it home for 2. And the Gamecocks have their first lead at 4-2. First points for Breezy. 2 minutes gone by. It's a 2-point lead for South Carolina. Van Lith across the timeline. The Louisville transfer. Dribbling to her right against Raven Johnson. Towards the Carolina bench. Now the Gamecocks switch as Breezy picks her up. Van Lith still on the dribble, gets a screen, comes around it to her right, goes underneath the baseline, feeds it up top, long jumper top of the key is good by Angel Reese. And we're tied at 4 as the player of the year in the SEC gets her first points. 7.5 minutes to play in the opening quarter. Raven Johnson up top, dribbling right, guarded by Van Lith in the man-to-man. Up top to Pow Pow. Now Kitts looking inside, not a lot there, 15 to shoot it. Work it left side to Breezy. Breezy around a screen to her left. To the corner, gets it to Kitts and threw it away. Amoro with the steal. She will go the length of the floor and lay it up and in. And the Gamecocks just got lazy with that pass. And it results in a layup. It's 6-4, 4 points for Amoro. And just an unforced turnover there. They lob it down low to Camilla. Camilla working against Angel Reese. Banks it up, no good. Fighting for the rebound. It's loose on the floor. And it'll go out of bounds off of Chloe Kitts. And right now the Gamecocks are just all thumbs. 6:58 to play in the opening quarter. It's 6-4 LSU with the basketball. Kent out for the Tigers and making her tournament appearance, the freshest legs of anybody, Michaela Williams, the SEC Freshman of the Year, who did not play in either of the first two games due to a minor foot injury. Flo J. Johnson drives into the lane, floats it up, no good. Rebound Camilla, and the Gamecocks have it. Clojay wanted a foul, didn't get it. Gamecocks down a bucket here, 6:40 to play in the opening quarter. Raven passes left to Breezy, thinks about it, takes a three, bad, no good. Hit the side of the rim and bounces out. Here come the Tigers in transition. Michaela Williams had the ball squirted out of her hands. It comes all the way across the Van Lith. Left wing three is good. Goodness, unlucky break for the Gamecocks as they knock the ball loose. It came all the way out to the other side, and Van Lith was wide open for three. She hits her 37th of the year, and the Gamecocks trail 9-4. Up top it comes to Pow Pow. Gamecocks need a bucket here. Pow Pow for three. Bang! Got it. Tahina Pow Pow gets the Gamecocks within a bucket at 9-7 with her first points. Second in the SEC in three-pointers made. It's her second, 72nd of the year. It's now 9-7. Gamecocks trail. Up top it comes to Morrow. Now to Angel Reese, right elbow. Reese playing traffic cop, gives it up to Flonjay Johnson. Trying to drive, and the ball was kicked out of bounds by South Carolina. It'll remain with LSU. 11 on the shot clock. 5:43 to play in the opening quarter. Gamecocks trail by a bucket. Van Lith will bring it in baseline left side. Still looking. Gets it in to Morrow. Picked up by Ashlyn Watkins, who just checked in, and Watkins blocks her shot. Watkins second in the SEC in blocks. Got one there. They zip it inside to Camilla. Beats her man, but blows the layup. Oh, my. Camilla wide open under the basket, and she blew the layup. Here comes LSU the other way. Van Lith for three, missed it short. Angel Reese with an offensive rebound. She'll drive the baseline. Reverse layup is good, and back to a four-point lead at an 11-7 as Reese gets her second bucket. And goodness, that's a big four-point swing there as Camilla missed the layup on the other end, and we give up a layup on the other end. Midway through the first, Gamecocks down four here in Greenville. Raven Johnson driving against Van Lith. Has her shot blocked by Van Lith. Reese with the rebound. Here come the Tigers in transition. Quickly down the floor. Flonjay Johnson right wing, guarded by Pow Pow. Gamecocks need a stop here. Stop and go dribble for Flonjay Johnson. Dumps it down low to Morrow. Backdoor cut and another uncontested layup. And the Gamecock defense going back to yesterday in the second half and the start of this first quarter leaves a lot to be desired. Here's Breezy Hall up top, getting beat on layups here. Here's Pow Pow left corner. Feeds it inside to Ashlyn Watkins. Watkins puts it up, back rimmed it no good, and nobody even crashing the boards for the Gamecocks. Everyone just standing around. Goodness. 4:20 to play in the first quarter. LSU leads it 13-7. Ball knocked out of bounds by Raven Johnson. That'll send us to a timeout. A very flat start for the Gamecocks, getting out hustled on both ends of the floor here. 13-7, LSU in front. Back in a moment for more Carolina basketball from Learfield. Speaking of rally, an update on Gamecock baseball over at Founders Park. They moved to the fifth inning there, and South Carolina now leads 8-6 as that game goes back and forth after long-winded tied it at 6 a minute ago. Gamecocks got another home run and tied that thing at 8-6 there. Gamecocks looking for their 8th SEC tournament title in the last 10 years. This is a top 10 matchup nationally. Second time the two teams have met, with the Gamecocks winning in Baton Rouge, erasing an 11-point deficit. But in a little hole here early, trailing by 6. On the floor, Raven Johnson, Breezy Hall, Camilla Cardoso, Ashlyn Watkins still in there and checking in for the first time. The freshman, Mileja Fulwiley, the rookie from Columbia, out of Keenan High School. It'll be LSU basketball looking to build on a 6-point lead. Van Lith will trigger it in on the sideline off to our right. And we're underway. She gets it up top to Angel Reese. Gamecocks on the man-to-man. Van Lith dribbling to her right. Onto the right wing. Gets a screen from Morrow, comes around it, drives into the lane. Oh, got away with a walk. No, there it is. They blew the whistle. Gamecocks will have it on the turnover by Van Lith. Carolina ball moving left to right. Down 6 here with 4 minutes to play in the opening quarter. Raven Johnson up top, Mileja Fulwiley around the screen, trying to back in, zips it right side to Raven. Back up top to Mileja. 13 to shoot it for Cardoso. Passes right side to Raven. Raven on the dribble. Up top. Fulwiley for three. Bang! Got it. Three-pointer. Mileja Fulwiley, her first points. And the Gamecocks are within three. 3:41 to play in the first quarter. Gamecocks have hit their second three. 13-10, Gamecocks trail. LSU with the basketball. Morrow up top, ball knocked loose. Van Lith will recover before it goes over and back. Dribbling right side, shot clock at 10. Van Lith behind the back, pass up top to Angel Reese. Long jumper won't go down. Out of bounds off the Gamecocks, they say. It'll remain with LSU. For Full Wiley, that was her 32nd three-pointer of the year. Was named to the SEC All-Freshman team. Van Lith will bring it in baseline left side for the Tigers. And going to get a foul right away in the Gamecocks. A hold there by Ashlyn Watkins, trying to prevent Morrow from getting loose. Can't afford to get those cheap fouls. Gamecocks need their depth. They get it in tomorrow. Ball knocked loose. Full Wiley comes out of there with it. She was fouled in the backcourt. All right, if you're going to call it close, call it both ways, and that'll be on Angel Reese, her first. So Carolina ball with 3:15 to play. LSU leads it 13-10 here in the opening quarter. Cardoso will trigger it in the backcourt to Raven, and we're back underway. Raven across the big SEC logo in the center of the floor. Dribbling right. Man-to-man defense from Van Lith. Looking inside, but they've got Cardoso bottled up by Angel Reese. Shot clock at 15 for Full Wiley up top. Driving in the lane. Almost forgot to take the ball with her. It's loose again. Picks it up. Needs help. Someone's got to come back and get it from her. Oh, how is that not a foul? They're going to call a held ball. Possession will stay with South Carolina. Flaujay Johnson had her wrapped up and pulled her down to the floor. My goodness. It remained with the Gamecocks, fortunately, on the alternating possession arrow. But Flaujay Johnson wrapped her up and pulled her down. Up top to Ashlyn Watkins, 7 to shoot it. Needs some help. Back out to Lay, left side, 3 to shoot it. Watkins will drive the baseline, and they're going to get her for an offensive foul, and that's 2 on Watkins here in the first quarter. Another garbage flop on the baseline by LSU, and the officials bought it. Worse than the FIFA World Cup out there. We'll get Fagan in. Watkins out with 2 early fouls. And that one was complete garbage. LSU ball leading 13-10 with 2:45 to play in the first. Here's Van Lith. Across the timeline, dribbling left, guarded by Raven Johnson. Feeds it left corner. Flaujay puts it on the floor, drives in the lane. Shot partially blocked. Morrow gets the rebound. Jumper no good over everything. Angel Reese gets the rebound. Shot blocked by Camilla. Follow-up shot blocked by Camilla. Ball loose on the floor. Held ball. Possession to LSU. And got the crowd reacting to the 2 blocks from Camilla Cardoso. Leads the SEC in blocks per game. That was a lot of contact by both teams. Angel Reese lowering her shoulder and banging into the defender. But they ain't going to call that on the SEC Player of the Year. Van Lith will bring it in baseline left side. Gamecocks still down 3, 7 on the shot clock. Van Lith, left baseline. How is that not a 5 count? They finally get it up top to Morrow. 5 seconds to shoot it. Morrow driving against Breezy. Dishes in the corner, Angel Reese. Angel Reese doesn't know that the shot clock's about to expire. There it goes. Gamecocks with the shot clock violation on defense there. That's more like it. And that gets the crowd into it. 2:16 to play in the first. Gamecocks still trail at 13-10. It hasn't been a thing of beauty here. Pow Pow back in. She'll pick up Raven Johnson. Freshman Tessa Johnson makes her debut in the title game. She'll pick up Breezy Hall. Tessa, the rookie from Albertville, Minnesota. But again, Ashlyn Watkins on the bench with 2 early fouls. Second one was more than questionable. Pow Pow across the timeline. Guarded by Van Lith in the man-to-man. Up top to Full Wiley. Full Wiley being guarded by Flaujay Johnson. Whistle away from the ball and a foul on Michaela Williams. Michaela Williams whistled for her first, and Williams seeing her first action of the tournament, as we told you. Did not play in the first 2 games due to a minor foot injury. So she's going to have the freshest legs of anybody. With both teams playing their 3rd game in 3 days. Here's Tessa Johnson up top to Full Wiley left side. Thought about the 3. She'll drive instead. Feeds it inside to Camilla, and Camilla will finish. She'll lay it up and in, and the Gamecocks within 1 at 13-12. Cardoso with 4 points, 1:50 to play here in the opening quarter. Van Lith up top, guarded closely by Full Wiley, dribbling left, passes up top to Morrow. To Angel Reese, they'll work it around the far side. Michaela Williams pulls up from the right elbow and buries her first shot. Back to a three-point lead of 15-12 as the SEC Freshman of the Year gets in the scoring column. Full Wiley the other way, drives, shoots, scores as she explodes across the baseline, and the Gamecocks again within one at 15-14. They caught the Tigers napping. Gamecocks within one with 1:18 to play in the opening quarter. There's Flaje Johnson, steps back into a 16-footer, no good. Van Lith got the rebound, however, as we didn't box her out. Got to do better than that. Jumper from Michaela Williams won't go down. It'll carom our way to Coach Lamont Paris, South Carolina men's basketball coach, sitting on press row with us today, along with Athletics Director Ray Tanner. So give Coach Paris the rebound. Gamecocks trailing 15-14 with 1:03 to play. Cardoso will come out, Chloe Kitts in. Malaysia Fulwiley out, Raven Johnson in. So to reset, it's the two Johnsons, Raven and Tessa, Fagan, Pow Pow, and Kitts with 1:03 to play. Here in the opening quarter, Kitts will trigger it into Pow Pow, and we'll get this thing back underway. Gamecocks down one, led early 4-2, and since then LSU has led. There's Fagan right wing, guarded by Aaliyah Del Rosario, who just checked in. Now Pow Pow left side. Pow Pow, left wing, gets it to Fagan on the baseline. Fagan trying to back her way in. Spin, shoot, missed it short. Rebound to LSU. 43 seconds to play in the quarter. LSU with a one-point lead. Williams in the near corner, puts it on the floor. Feeds it out, ball knocked loose by Pow Pow. Pow Pow, one girl to beat as she races down the length of the floor and lays it up and in. And the Gamecocks reclaim the lead, 16-15. That gets the crowd back into it. 25 seconds to play in the quarter. The Tigers can work for the final shot to try to take the lead here at the end of the first frame. Flaje Johnson up top, guarded by Tessa Johnson. Down to 10 seconds. Now they'll start their offense. Around a screen to her right, back to her left. Ball knocked loose. Gamecocks come out of there with it. Long lead pass for Tessa. 2 seconds to play. Goes up. She's fouled with 1.3 seconds to play by Haley Van Lith. And that'll send the freshman to the free throw line. Defense answering the bell after it was very porous to start. Gamecocks have gotten a few stops here down the stretch. They lead it 16-15, and the freshman Tessa Johnson will be at the line looking for her first points. Gamecocks with back-to-back steals here. First visit to the free throw line by either team in this first quarter. First one from Tessa is good, and the Gamecocks lead 17-15. One more time for Tessa Johnson, the freshman. 82% on the year, and she hits them both. Three-point lead for the Gamecocks. And it's a 7-0 run. We'll put some pressure in the backcourt to try to prevent a last-second shot. Fagan intercepts. Three-pointer at the buzzer won't go down. And that's how the first quarter will end. Well, Fagan with the steal there at midcourt. Couldn't knock it down, but a 7-0 run to end the first quarter, and the Gamecocks have a three-point lead over LSU, 18-15 after one. 10 minutes in the books. Second quarter coming up after this. You're listening to Carolina Basketball from Learfield. LSU leads the SEC in rebounds. Gamecocks are second, but right now it's LSU dominating the glass. They've out-rebounded the Gamecocks 12-5. Carolina's going to have to do a better job, and they're going to have to do it without one of their better rebounders, as Ashlyn Watkins picked up two early fouls in that first quarter. May not see her the rest of the half, and that is a big force not in there for South Carolina right now. First one was a silly foul by Ashlyn. The second one was a questionable flop that they got Watkins for on an offensive foul. See if the Gamecocks can keep it going here. These two teams met in the regular season in Baton Rouge, and it was the Gamecocks winning 76-70, overcoming an 11-point deficit. Trailed early here 13-7, and now lead at 18-5. Sold out here in Greenville. They were sold out yesterday for the semifinals, sold out here again today, about 13,000 seats here at the Bon Secours Wellness Arena. It'll be LSU basketball, or I'm sorry, South Carolina basketball to start the second quarter. We'll start the second quarter. Raven Johnson, Tessa Johnson, Tahina Pow Pow, Chloe Kitts, and Sanaya Fagan. So the same group that was out there to end the first frame. Raven sporting the new red locks this week. She went blonde at the end of the season. Now she's got the regular season. Now she's got the bright red, similar to what Camilla used to wear. Here's Raven up top, bounce pass to the right to Pow Pow. Pow Pow had her pocket picked and stolen away by Flau J. Johnson in the top 10 in steals, and she just took it away from Tahina. She's done that a lot in this tournament. Van Lith up top, working on Raven in the man-to-man, dribbling just in front of us to her left. Up top to Anissa Morrow, one-on-one with Kitts. Morrow's had the better of that matchup. Feeds it down low. Somehow they get it to Angel Reese, but she walked with it. Fagan was fronting her, and the pass carried her into the baseline. Wasn't sure how she caught it over Fagan anyway, but the Gamecocks will take it on the turnover. Now you got to convert it to points. The lead is 3, 18-15 for the Gamecocks, just underway in the second quarter. Raven passes right to Pow Pow. Up top to Kitts. Got to move it quickly against these quick hands of LSU. To Raven now, 15 to shoot it. Raven around a screen, trying to create. To Chloe Kitts up top, straightaway jumper, got it! Chloe Kitts with the bucket, and the Gamecocks lead 20-15. A 9-0 run for the Gamecocks. Here comes LSU over on the far side. Top of the circle it comes. Morrow wants three, and she buries it. Anissa Morrow, only 21% from that range. She hits her 12th of the year, and that ends that 9-0 run to cut the deficit down to two. We go inside to Chloe Kitts. She will drive, shoot, score between a couple of defenders. Back to a four-point lead. Back-to-back buckets by Kitts makes it 22-18. 8.5 minutes to play here in the second quarter. Van Lith up top to Angel Reese. Fagan backs up about 6 feet off her. Now she'll step into an 18-footer. Back rimmed it, no good. Lost out of bounds to the Gamecocks. Anissa Morrow claiming she was pushed from behind, but not going to win that battle. Carolina ball, leading by four. Raven Johnson will bring it up. 8.5 minutes to play in the second quarter. It has sold out Bon Secours Wellness Arena. Raven across the SEC logo. Guarded by Van Lith. Comes around a screen from Kitts to her left. Drives the baseline, pulls it up and in off the glass. Raven Johnson uses the square, and the Gamecocks lead is six. First points for Raven. Here comes Van Lith the other way. Around a screen from Morrow. Passes left corner. Three ball away from Kent, and she buries it. Janae Kent was 2 for 22 from three-point range on the season, and she just buried one from the corner. My goodness, that's not even on the scouting report. 2 for 22, and she hits it. They're two three-point shots by non-three-point makers. Here's Raven Johnson, right corner three ball, in and out, no good. Fagan had the rebound and lost it out of bounds. It'll be LSU ball. Gamecocks lead is trimmed 24-21. You have Kent, who was 2 for 22, hitting that three a moment ago. Morrow, a 21% three-point shooter, hit one before that. So LSU going against the scouting report. They work it right side to Flau J. Johnson. Back up top to Morrow, stab at the ball, whistle away from the ball, and going to have a foul on the Gamecocks. That'll be on Sanaya Fagan as she collects her first, day of the team's first. 7:22 to play here in the second quarter. Van Lith will bring it in baseline right side for the Tigers. Looking inside, got to hurry to avoid the five. That's a five count. Good defense by the Gamecocks as Van Lith took forever to try to get that ball in. Gamecocks have it. Lead is just three at 24-21. Raven right wing, guarded by Van Lith to Chloe Kitts. She'll drive the lane. Oh, and they're going to get her for an offensive foul. Another flop job. My goodness, they know how to act. Are the Oscars tonight? Because send the Tigers to Hollywood for this. That is ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. Maybe they'll review it, because that was horrendous. Gamecocks still leading 24-21. That was absolutely terrible. 7:13 to play. We've got a timeout on the floor. Gamecocks lead LSU 24-21. Back in a moment for more Carolina basketball from Learfield. Basketball. As we wait for TV to give us permission, update on Gamecock baseball. They now lead at Longwood in the bottom of the fifth inning, 9-6, batting with two outs and the bases loaded. On the floor for the Gamecocks in their home whites, Camilla Cardoso back into the lineup, along with Tahina Pau-Pau. Tahina Pau-Pau, Tessa Johnson, Raven Johnson, Sanaya Fagan. Looking at the replay again, they may have kept the call because they're going to say that Chloe Kitz's elbow is extended. So that'll be the ruling for the offensive foul, even though the offensive foul, even though the defender did not have position, was moving. Here's Van Lith across the timeline, picked up by Raven Johnson. Dribbling left. Tight man-to-man coverage here. Up top to Flajay Johnson. Trying to tie her up with Tessa Johnson. Stop and go dribble, lost the handle, but it goes right to Angel Reese. Gets it back to Flajay, 9 to shoot it. To Van Lith up top. Van Lith guarded by Raven, puts it on the floor. Drive, shoot, partially blocked by Camilla. Rebound, Pau-Pau, and the Gamecocks have it. Camilla Cardoso having her personal block party here. Here's Raven up top. She'll spot up for three. Bang! Got it. Three-pointer, Raven Johnson, her 21st of the year, and the Gamecocks lead 27-21. 5 points for Raven, and a big three ball there. Here come the Tigers. Working around to Van Lith, right side. Back up top. Three ball away from Morrow. Left it short. Camilla tips the rebound to Raven, and the Gamecocks have it. Outlet to Pau-Pau, left side. Pau-Pau terminates the dribble. Gets it to Fagan in the left corner. Fagan up top to Camilla. Working right side to Raven. Raven with 15 to shoot it. Around a screen. Can't get the pick and roll working. Pau-Pau left wing. To Fagan. Back to Pau-Pau for three, left side. In and out, no good. Rebound Angel Reese. Had a good look. Pau-Pau couldn't knock it down. Here come the Tigers. Still 27-21 Gamecocks. Lob it inside. Stolen away by Fagan. And the Gamecocks have it. Raven driving in the lane. Dumps it down to Camilla, but she forgot to catch it. Pau-Pau will catch up to it before it can go out of bounds. Catch a break there. 5.5 minutes to play in the second quarter. Zip it right corner. Tessa, right wing Raven. Another three. Off the front rim, no good. Fight for the rebound, and Flaugier's got it for the Tigers. Gamecocks have had some good looks from distance. Can't knock them down here the last couple of trips. Flaugier, right side. Center defender sprawling. Open jumper is good. It's a three, they say, and the lead is cut in half at 27-24. Raven Johnson went sprawling, and that left Flajay Johnson wide open for three. She hits her 28th of the year. Midway through the second quarter, Gamecocks lead at 27-24. Need an answer here. We've come up empty in our last few trips, settling for shots from the outside, although they were open looks. Here's Pau-Pau up top. Drives into the lane. Zips it to Raven. She wants three from the corner. No good, and the Gamecocks getting too happy with their three-point shot. They're not going down. Carolina 3-for-10 from distance. Here comes LSU. Gamecocks lead is just three. Haven't scored in a while. Here's Van Lith dribbling to her right, guarded by Pau-Pau. Looking inside and going to get an offensive foul on Angel Reese. Mixing it up with Camilla Cardoso, and that's two on the SEC Player of the Year. We'll get Malaysia Fulwiley into the contest, the freshman. And they'll get Reese out. Aaliyah Del Rosario checks in, the big 6'6 freshman from the Bronx, New York. 4:33 to play in this one in the second quarter. Gamecocks lead at 27-24. And a time was called just so they can review something here on that last play to see if maybe there were some shenanigans before or if Angel Reese did something. Oh, Angel Reese, yeah, when she got called for the foul, she threw an elbow into the chops of Camilla Cardoso. Yeah, that's what they're looking at now. That could easily be a flagrant. They called an offensive foul on Chloe Kitz for the elbow. They did call the foul on Angel Reese. So we'll see if this is anything further than that. Not a full timeout, just a review, so we'll keep it right here. As it stands, 4:33 to play in the second quarter. Gamecocks in front of LSU, 27-24. The winner gets the league's automatic bid to the NCAA tournament. Not that either one of these teams is worried about that. Update on Gamecock baseball. Now leading 10-6 over Longwood in the bottom of the fifth inning in a high-scoring affair at Founders Park. Gamecocks trying to sweep that series. Gamecocks softball trailing Texas A&M in game three of that series 2-1. Lost a 2-1 game yesterday. Gamecocks batting with one out. And runners at second and third in the top of the seventh, the last chance for Gamecock softball to avoid the sweep at Texas A&M. Meanwhile, here in Greenville, they're still reviewing that last play. They did call the foul on Angel Reese, which was her second. But we'll see if it's anything more. Gamecocks have gotten a little too three-point happy the last few trips down the floor. After they hit one, they've missed their last three. Have not been able to get the ball inside. Maybe they can do something with Angel Reese not in there, but you still got big 6'6", Aaliyah Del Rosario in there. Three officials still huddled around the scorer's table to discuss what they saw. They did call the foul on Angel Reese as she extended her arms and elbows. That caught Camilla in the chops. And we'll see what they're going to call. They're explaining it to Coach Kim Mulkey now. And did they call a flagrant or no? We won't get the explanation. They'll let TV know, so we'll see if we can get that explanation. So it is upgraded to an intentional foul. That'll put the Gamecocks at the free throw line. And Tina Pau-Pau will shoot the free throws here. Gamecocks lead is just three with 4:33 to play in the second quarter. Tahina hits the first one, gives her 6 points, and it's 28-24. One more time for Pau-Pau. 85% free throw shooter, and she calmly hits them both. 5-point lead for the Gamecocks, and they get the ball back after the intentional foul. So the Gamecocks will have it. Fagan triggers it into Pau-Pau at the SEC logo. We're back underway. Guarded by Van Lithen, the man-to-man. Tight man-to-man coverage here by the Tigers. Up top to Tessa. Tessa, stop and go dribble left side. Around a screen to her right from Camilla. Pulls up. Shot up, no good. But she was fouled by Big Del Rosario. They switched on the screen, and the 6'6 player, who had a good chance to block the shot, got some skin against Tessa Johnson. And now Tessa will be at the line. She's got 2 points, both from the charity stripe here today. Tessa at the stripe, first one, good. And the Gamecocks lead 30-24, matching their largest lead of 6 points. One more time for Tessa. Yes, ma'am. And the Gamecocks have a 7-point lead at 31-24. Here come the Tigers moving right to left. Van Lith across the timeline, guarded by Fulweiler. Picks up the dribble, passes up top to Morrow. Stab at the basketball, ball knocked loose. Morrow trying to recover, it goes out of bounds to the Gamecocks. Great defensive play to knock that ball loose, and the Gamecocks will have it. Let's see if they can keep this defensive pressure up. 7-point lead for Carolina with 4:04 to play in the second quarter. Tina Pau-Pau will bring it up for the Gamecocks. Going to struggle to get it inside against this big LSU squad. Here's Tessa running the weave up top with Pau-Pau, dribbling to her right. Pau-Pau down low, Camilla. Camilla had the ball knocked out of her hands and stolen away by Del Rosario. So a missed opportunity there. Here comes Flajay Johnson, guarded by Fulwiley. Gives it up to Van Lith now. Van Lith passes left to Johnson, guarded by Lay. Gets a screen, comes around it to her right. Steps back into an 18-footer, makes it, and she's fouled by Camilla. And Slaugier will be at the line for a three-point play, and that ends that little run. It's 31-26. The Gamecocks switched defensively, but Camilla made the mistake of extending her arm out instead of keeping it straight up. Got to keep the arm up, you won't get the foul. Slaugier Johnson will be at the line. She's got 5 points. The sophomore, named second-team All-SEC, a 76% foul shooter. Follow-up free throw is good, and it's a three-point play. The lead down to four at 31-27. Here comes Pau-Pau, gets it across to Fagan, pass it left to Fulweiler. Fulweiler around a screen, up top to Cardoso. Cardoso to Pau-Pau right side, trying to create, driving to the top of the circle. Needs help, feeds it to Camilla right baseline. Zip it to Lay, deep three left wing, in and out no good, and a rebound by LSU. Morrow, who swung the arms after the rebound, getting a little testy out there. Lead down to four, LSU with the basketball, 3:05 to play. In the second quarter, Van Lith, tomorrow at the free throw line, drives the lane right side, puts it high off the glass, no good. stick back won't go. Del Rosario goes up and she's fouled. Goodness. Gamecocks just cannot get a rebound today, getting killed under the boards. 17-8, they're out rebounding the Gamecocks today. Big 6'6 Del Rosario doing her job, and she'll be at the line for a pair. 2:55 to play. We'll get Camilla out. Sakima Walker in for the first time, the senior from Columbus, Ohio. Give Camilla a blow. Remember, Ashlyn Watkins on the bench with two fouls early in the first quarter. That's why she hasn't been in. Aaliyah Del Rosario, the 6'6 freshman from the Bronx, named to the SEC All-Freshman team, is at the line. And she hits the first free throw. She's only a 57% free throw shooter, but looked buttery smooth on that one. One more time. Second free throw, left it short. Fagan with the rebound, Gamecocks have it. Just a three-point lead now. It's 31-28 Gamecocks. Lob it down low. Inside to Walker, spins, shoots, doesn't score, missed everything. My goodness, that was ugly. Rebound, here comes LSU in transition. Flaje Johnson on the right wing. Gamecocks lead is just three, it was 7 moments ago. Flaje puts it on the floor, pull-up jumper from the baseline, rolls off the rim, no good. Fight for the rebound, out of bounds to the Gamecocks. Gamecocks need a good set here. LSU's got the momentum. After the Gamecocks had a 7-point lead, they've scored the last 4 points, and the Gamecocks have really struggled to get it going inside, and the 3 points just aren't falling with regularity, just 3 out of 11. Pow Pow across the timeline, working around the man-to-man left side to Fulweiler. Fulweiler around a screen, drives in the lane, pull-up jumper, rattles out, no good. My goodness, nothing going down. Went halfway down and popped out. Here come the Tigers in transition. Van Lith all by herself for three, missed it, and Williams gets the rebound. Gamecocks just not boxing out here. Michaela Williams pulls up from the baseline, left it short, rebounds to Kima Walker, and the Gamecocks have it. Outlet to Fulweiler. Fulweiler in transition. Fulweiler will lay it up and in. She goes coast to coast, and the Gamecocks lead 33-28. Fulweiler with the big bucket there to give the Gamecocks some momentum. 1:48 to play in the second quarter. It's a 5-point lead for the Gamecocks. Fulweiler with 7 points in the first half. Williams feeds it inside to Del Rosario. Shot up, no good, but a foul on Sakima Walker is going to put her at the line. And like yesterday, the Gamecocks struggling with the fouls. They gave Tennessee way too many opportunities yesterday at the free throw line to allow them to climb back in it. You don't want to see that happen again today. Del Rosario at the line where she's 1 for 2 today. We'll get Breezy Hall back in. She'll pick up Tessa Johnson. So Del Rosario at the line. 1:37 to play in the half. Gamecocks clinging to a 5-point lead. But the big freshman at the stripe. First of two. Missed it short. 1 more time for the freshman. Crowd behind the goal stanchion. Partisan Gamecock fans trying to give Del Rosario what for. Missed it again. Fight for the rebound. Morrow gets it. Oh, and she's going to be fouled. Morrow swinging the elbows to create separation. And they're going to go to the line for two more with a much better free throw shooter. Morrow, very physical out there, but they're letting her do it. And she's an 82% foul shooter, fourth in the SEC. Missed opportunity there as we didn't box out after the misses, and she hits the first one. Make it 33-29. The lead is trimmed. Foul stacking up. Gamecocks over the limit here in the second quarter. There's the first on Breezy. And Morrow hits both free throws. The lead down to three at 33-30. Gamecocks could use a bucket here. Up top, Fagan passes right to Fulweiler to the top of the circle, trying to drive into the lane, kick it out to Pow Pow, and she threw it away. Fulweiler trying to do a little too much that time and give it back to LSU. 7-point lead is down to three, and LSU looks to cut into that here. 1:20 to play in the half. Van Lith across the timeline, guarded by Breezy Hall. Gamecocks need a good set here defensively. Van Lith up top to Morrow. Morrow feeds it inside to Van Lith, and she walked with it. Yes, she did. It was going to be blocked anyway by Fagan, but it will be Carolina ball with 1:10 to play in the half. Pow Pow will bring it up for the Gamecocks. Gets it across the SEC logo. Guarded by Van Lith. Comes around a screen to her left. Pow Pow to Fagan up top. Dumps it down low to Sakima. Coming out of the paint. Back to Breezy right wing. Doesn't shoot the three, but she was open. Shot clock at 10 now for Pow Pow. Pow Pow top of the circle. Steps back. Gets her man in the air. Pulls up for three. Off the front rim. No good. Walker with the rebound, and the Gamecocks have it. Out to Breezy. Gamecocks will settle into the half court. Off the offensive board. Here's Pow Pow left side, guarded by Van Lith. Works it left side, Fulwiley in the far corner for three. Bang! Got it! Three-pointer, Mylesa Fulwiley in the Gamecocks lead. 36-30. Big three from Lay with 25 seconds to go. LSU can work for the final shot. Up top is Van Lith, guarded by Fulwiley. 9 seconds to play. Around a screen to her left. Takes an 18-footer and buries it with 5 seconds to play. Makes it 36-32. 1 second to play. Triggered into Fulwiley, and that's how the first half will end. 20 minutes in the books. We've got a good one here. South Carolina leading LSU at the intermission of the SEC Tournament Championship game. It's 36-32, South Carolina over LSU. Good 20 minutes of basketball. We'll see who's got the legs for the second half. Back in a moment. Start our halftime report after this. It's Carolina basketball from Learfield. Back in Greenville, we're at halftime of the 2024 SEC Women's Basketball Tournament Championship game. South Carolina leading LSU at the break, 36-32. Added several lead changes in that first half. Gamecocks' largest lead was 7, and it's down to 4 here at the break. We'll have stats and highlights coming up, but first let's get you caught up on what else is happening. First in Gamecock sports, and game 3 of the 3-game series at Founders Park between South Carolina and Longwood. Gamecocks looking to sweep that 3-game series, and they lead it in not a pitcher's duel today. 11-6, Gamecocks leading Longwood 16-6. Most recent damage, a 3-run home run from South Carolina outfielder Kennedy Jones. So Gamecocks looking to sweep that 3-game series. Here, South Carolina and LSU. See what the Gamecocks can do. As we said, getting killed under the boards, but still have a 4-point lead. See if Ashlyn Watkins is able to get involved after picking up 2 fouls early in that first quarter and had to sit the bench the rest of the way, one of South Carolina's more dynamic players. Angel Reese was also in foul trouble in that first half, had 2 fouls, including a flagrant, so she had to sit the bench the final stretch in the second quarter. We'll see what the second half brings. Again, the inability to get the ball inside. It has been a struggle for South Carolina. Gamecocks in the home whites, LSU in their road purple. This sellout crowd, mostly garnet and black, but a lot of purple and gold as well here. On the floor to start the third quarter for the Gamecocks, Raven Johnson, Tahina Powpow, Breezy Hall, Chloe Kitts, Camilla Cardoso. It'll be LSU basketball to start the third quarter, moving left to right, and they'll have their original starting five. It'll be Flauje Johnson to trigger it in at midcourt. And we're underway as Haley Van Lith will bring it up. 20 minutes to decide an SEC tournament champion. Van Lith up top, guarded by Raven. Dribbling to her right. Still has it on the floor. Finally gives it up top to Morrow. One-on-one with Kitts. Drives into the lane, floats it up. Missed the layup this time. They get the rebound, however. And they're going to call a held ball. Possession to South Carolina. Kitts tied it up, and then Janae Kent got a hand in there for LSU, so South Carolina ball. Morrow had a quick start to the first half, had a couple of layups early, blowing past Chloe Kitts. Couldn't finish that time. Let's hope the Gamecocks can defend her a little bit better. Raven Johnson will bring it up for the Gamecocks. Picked up by Van Lith and their man-to-man. Passes right to Breezy Hall in front of the Carolina bench. Breezy trying to get everyone moving, but they look a little bit confused offensively here. Shot clock at 13. Breezy driving the right baseline, cut off, circles back out of there. Got to give it up to somebody. Up top to Pow Pow. Eyes the shot clock, 5 to shoot it. Raven left wing, puts it on the floor against Van Lith. Baseline jumper, missed it short. Fight for the rebound, and Tigers come out of there with it. Morrow pulled it away from Breezy. Here come the Tigers. Driving the baseline is Kent. Misses the layup runner. Rebound to Breezy, and the Gamecocks have it. Gamecocks were slow to get back. Fortunately, Kent couldn't get past Cardoso. Breezy drives, shoots, scores!
off-balance running layup, and the Gamecocks will be at the line for a three-point play. It's 38-32. Don't know how Breezy got that one to go, but she did. She was falling awkwardly away to her left, her non-dominant hand. It's her 4 points, and she'll be at the line for the and one. The junior from Dayton, Ohio. Tigers will go to the bench as Kent is out. Michaela Williams will check in. Again, the only one in this tournament with fresh legs, as she didn't play in the first two games due to a minor foot injury, but she was the SEC Freshman of the Year. Follow-up free throw is good from Breezy, a 77% free throw shooter, and the Gamecocks matched their largest lead, 39-32, with a minute gone by here in the third quarter. Here's Van Lith dribbling right, guarded by Raven in the man-to-man. Up top tomorrow, feeds it down low, looking for Angel Reese, almost took it out of bounds, but she saves it, gets it in the corner to Flage. Inside to Angel Reese, beats Camilla, but then Camilla comes from behind, and they're going to get Camilla for a foul. Thought Camilla got a clean block, but instead it's her third foul, and now the Gamecocks really struggling with foul trouble. Looked like a clean block from behind. Camilla's pointing to the video board where they're showing the replay, but that's not something they're going to overturn. She'll come out now in favor of Fagan, and she might have a case there. Unless she got her with the body, she definitely blocked the shot. Angel Reese at the line. She's got 4 points, 7 rebounds, the SEC Player of the Year. Misses the first free throw, which is news, a 74% free throw shooter. Coach Staley talking to one of the officials. Not happy, perhaps, about that last call. Reese hits one out of two, and it's 39-33 Gamecocks. 8:40 to play in the third quarter here in Greenville. Pow will bring it up for South Carolina. Passes left to Breezy Hall. Breezy gets it to Kitts, coming out of the paint left side, puts it on the floor against Morrow, puts an awkward shot up, no good. Rebound, Michaela Williams of LSU. Couldn't finish that time. Here they come in transition. Flauje Johnson on the run, spinning into the lane, steps back, jumper up, no good. Rebound Kitts, and the Gamecocks have it. Outlet to Raven, to Breezy Hall left side. Now to Pow left wing for three, bang! Three-pointer. Tahina Pow, wide open, the trailer on the play, hits her second of the game, and the Gamecocks have their largest lead of 9 points at 42-33, and Coach Kim Mulkey of the Tigers is going to burn a timeout. We'll step aside as well. You're listening to Carolina Basketball from Learfield. The inside game going all day. Good to see Pow hit some shots in the first two games of the SEC tournament. She was just 3 for 16 from the field. She's 3 out of 6 today and tied for high honors for the Gamecocks with 10 points. Update on Gamecock baseball. They continue to pour it on Longwood, leading 18-6 in the bottom of the sixth inning at Founders Park. LSU basketball as play resumes and the road purple moving left to right. They'll have to go the length of the floor. Gamecocks matching up in the backcourt as Flauje Johnson will trigger it in to Haley Van Lith, and we're underway. They're walking across the SEC logo, dribbling to her right. Gamecocks have stayed in the man-to-man. Up top it comes to Morrow, guarded by Kitts, feed it inside, whistle away from the ball, and what's this? They called a foul on Saniya Fagan, and my goodness, as physical as this game has been, what did she do? That didn't look like much. And a call for a little bit of a hold, I guess. But it's been very physical. They've let a lot of stuff go, but not on this trip. Get it into Angel Reese, right side, working on Fagan, drives into the lane, floats it up, no good. Fagan with the rebound, and the Gamecocks have it. Outlet to Raven. Now Breezy Hall left wing, doesn't pull the trigger on a quick three. Gamecocks will settle into the half court. 7:45 to play in the third. And a foul up top on Michaela Williams. She'll pick up her second as she gave a big bump to Breezy Hall. Carolina ball, they'll bring it in on the sideline. Off to our right, Kitts gets it into Raven. We're back underway. One-on-one with Van Lith. Shot clock at 15. Working right side to Breezy. On the wing in front of Coach Dawn Staley. Breezy, guarded closely by Williams, around a screen to the top of the circle, passes left with 5 to shoot it to Raven. Raven, on the pick and roll inside, it's knocked loose out of bounds. It'll be Carolina ball, but just 2.9 seconds on the shot clock. Gamecocks will bring it in baseline left side. They want Pau Pau to do it. See if Pau Pau, if they do on the give and go to Pau Pau. Get it into Fagan, back to Pau Pau, back to Fagan inside, jumper up and in. Fagan gets it to swirl in, and the Gamecocks have their first double-digit lead at 44-33 with 7:15 to play in the contest. That gets the crowd into it. Lau J. Johnson up top, Angel Reese puts it on the floor with the left hand, floats it high off the glass, no good. Gets your own rebound, follow-up no good. Morrow with the rebound, her follow-up won't go. Breezy with the rebound, and the Gamecocks have it. Breezy will take it to the rack herself and miss the layup. Chloe Kitts with the rebound, stick back no good, but she's fouled. Got to have to get it from the free throw line, and Angel Morrow is going to do, or rather Anissa Morrow is going to do some more crying to the official. With as physical as she has played, she can't cry about anything. So it'll be Carolina at the free throw line with 6:51 to play in the third quarter. Still a long way to go, but it's an 11-point lead. And as we saw yesterday, no lead is too safe after the Gamecocks squandered a 23-point lead yesterday but ended up winning. Kitts at the line for the first time today. A quiet day, just 4 points. And she hits the first one. They make it 45-33. 6:51 to play in the third. Kitts, the sophomore. Only a 65% foul shooter, but she hits them both. And the Gamecocks lead 46-33. Here come the Tigers moving left to right. Man-to-man as Van Lith gets it across. Pau Pau picks her up. She's on the right wing now. Back up top, they feed it inside to Angel Reese. Working on Fagan, and Fagan had the block, but then went right back in her hands. Gamecocks wanted a held ball, didn't get it, and that snaps that little run to make it 46-35. Coach Stelly screaming for a held ball, didn't get it. Fagan thought she had it too. But got to keep playing. There's Breezy up top. Gamecocks lead down to 11. Raven between the rings, guarded by Van Lith. Dribbling to her left, shot clock at 10. Around a screen from Fagan to the top of the circle. Passes left to Breezy. Down low to Fagan. Fagan working the baseline. Reverse layup. Won't go down. Rebound Morrow. Not a high percentage shot there. And then Raven Johnson with a steal in the backcourt. Misses the bank shot. Fagan with the rebound. Has her shot blocked and she's fouled. Anissa Morrow will be whistled for her first foul. And that'll send the Gamecocks to the line again. A lot of momentum in this game, a lot of jawing back and forth between these two teams. Fagan will be at the line for the first time, just 2 points today for the junior from Ellenwood, Georgia. Hasn't been at the line much, and only a 67% foul shooter. And yeah, didn't get the first one, got every bit of iron and it rolled off. And that's the first miss for the Gamecocks today from the line. They were 9 for 9 prior to that one. One more time for Fagan. And she missed them both. Morrow gets the rebound. So missed opportunity there as Fagan misses them both. Still just an 11-point lead. 5:50 to play in the third. LSU with the basketball. Van Lith dribbling left towards Coach Kim Mulkey and the LSU bench. Picks up the dribble. Up top, Del Rosario. Underneath the basket. It goes back to Del Rosario. Banks it in. She's fouled. Count the basket. Chance for a 3-point play. And a little momentum swing here after the Gamecocks missed 2 free throws. And now you get a 3-point play for Del Rosario. The lead is cut to single digits at 46-37 after leading by 13 a moment ago. Chloe Kitts out, Raven Johnson out, Malaysia Fulwiley and Ashlyn Watkins back in. Watkins' first appearance since the first quarter, early in the first quarter when she picked up 2 fouls. Last foul was on Kitts, by the way, her second. Del Rosario at the line, 3 points today. And a follow-up free throw is good, makes it 46-38, and the lead is trimmed. A mini 5-0 run here by the Tigers as we approach the midpoint of the third quarter. Not going to keep them down for long. Here's Pau Pau up top to Breezy. Breezy around a screen to her left. Comes off another screen from Fagan to her right. Reese takes her on the switch. Shot clock at 10. Watkins up top. Hands it off to Pau Pau. Deep three right wing. In and out, no good. Fagan fighting for the rebound, can't get it. Angel Reese has got it. And here come the Tigers, trying to get on a little bit of a run here. Lead is down to 8. Van Lith up top, working on Fulwiley, goes for the steal, doesn't get it. Van Lith dribbling to her left. Shot clock halfway down to 15. Oh, there's a big push off. They don't call it by Van Lith. Get it inside to Morrow, and they're going to get a foul on the Gamecocks. How do you not call the push off on the forearm shiver? Ridiculous. Foul on Fagan is her third. It'll be LSU ball when we come back. 4:54 to play in the third. Gamecocks lead is down to 8 at 46-38. Back in a moment for more Carroll 11. Gamecocks continuing to struggle under the glass as LSU has out-rebounded the Gamecocks 29-19. LSU the top rebounding team in the SEC. Gamecocks are second. Update on Gamecock baseball. Still batting in the bottom of the sixth. Gamecocks leading Longwood in game three of that series 22-6. Yeah, that's a baseball game. Goodness gracious. On the floor for the Gamecocks in their home whites as they break their huddle. It's Breezy Hall, Ashlyn Watkins, Malaysia Fulwiley, Sanaya Fagan, and Tahina Pau-Pau. It'll be Anissa Morrow at the free throw line. She's got 11 points, 6 rebounds. She's 2-for-2 from the stripe today. An 82% foul shooter, which is fourth in the SEC. Morrow, the junior from Chicago, in her first season with LSU after transferring from DePaul, earned first-team All-SEC honors this year. At the line here, first one is good. Tigers 7 out of 11 from the free throw line. They came in third in the SEC in free throw shooting. And it's a 6-0 run here by the Tigers. Second one for Morrow, got them both. And just like that, the lead down to 6. 7-0 run by LSU. Quiets the South Carolina crowd. Pau-Pau will get it across for the Gamecocks. Man-to-man from Cloud J. Johnson. Gamecocks should use a bucket here. Up top it comes to Fulwiley. Around a screen to her right, splits a couple of defenders, drives, shoots, scores! How did she get it to go? It's a dozen for Fulwiley, and the Gamecocks lead 48-40. She looked out of control, split a couple of defenders, and somehow got it to go. Van Lith up top, looking inside. Up top to Morrow. We try to tie it up, and late whistle and a foul is going to put LSU at the free throw line as the Gamecocks are over the limit. We tried to tie it up and got a little over-aggressive, I guess. Fulwiley thought she had a tie-up, sneaking in on the double team. And instead, we'll send Anissa Morrow to the line again. And this was the recipe for disaster yesterday. You can't put good free throw shooting teams on the line when you've got a big lead. And they did it all in the second half yesterday, and Tennessee was able to climb back. They hit their free throws. Morrow hits the first one, and you especially can't send an 84% free throw shooter to the line. You can't take those chances. Morrow hits the first one. Second one coming up. She's got 14 points now. She's 5-for-5. Make it 6-for-6 from the stripe. And the lead down to 6 again, 48-42. Can't keep giving them those chances. There's Pau-Pau across the SEC logo. Guarded by Flau J. Johnson. Passes left to Lay. Lay guarded by Van Lith. To Fagan now. Back to Lay. Lay wants 3 from the left wing. Bang! Got it! Malaysia Fulwiley gives the Gamecocks a 9-point lead, 51-42 on her third three-pointer. Del Rosario drives, shoots, and gets a layup, and the Gamecocks olayed defensively there. You hate to see that. You get a big momentum boost on a three-pointer, and you give up a layup within 5 seconds. Watkins gets it to Fulwiley, and she fumbled the basketball. It's going to squirt out of there, but Hall recovers. Let's pull it back out and set the half court. Goodness. 7-point lead for the Gamecocks. Fulwiley, right wing three. Bang! Got it again! Back-to-back threes from Fulwiley. And the Gamecocks lead is 10 with 3:30 to play in the third. My goodness, she's got 18 points. She's only a 30% three-point shooter. They feed it inside to Morrow. Morrow will lay it up, no good. Rebound Pau-Pau, and the Gamecocks have it. Pau-Pau almost forgot to take the ball with her. Pau-Pau signaling the play. We'll run the half court. Gamecocks lead is 10. Largest lead was 13. To Ashlyn Watkins. Pull up in the paint. Won't bank in, but a foul will send the Gamecocks to the line. As the Tigers are now over the limit with 3:07 to play in the third. See who they put it on. We'll get Tessa Johnson into the game. The freshman will pick up Breezy Hall. Foul was on Del Rosario, her second. And it'll be Ashlyn Watkins at the line, and unfortunately for the Gamecocks, not who you want there. Watkins has not been a good free throw shooter this year, just 56%. Freshman of the year in the SEC, Michaela Williams back into the contest. She picks up Del Rosario. Raven Johnson will pick up Pau-Pau for the Gamecocks. So here's Watkins. Only taking one shot today because she got two early fouls in the first quarter, hadn't played much. See if she can get it from the stripe, a place she has struggled mightily this year. Earned second team All-SEC honors. But hits the first one, nothing but net. And it's 55-44. One more time for Watkins, the sophomore. And the next one swirls out no good. Angel Reese with another rebound. LSU has it, 11-point lead for the Gamecocks with 3 minutes to play in the third. They lob it down, Roger Leach, knocked away. Gamecocks come out of there with it. Full Wiley, one girl to beat. She will lay it up and in, and she beats Van Lith to the spot. Gamecocks match their largest lead of 13 points at 57-44. 2:50 to play in the third. Van Lith fumbles the basketball but recovers. That gets the crowd back into it. Van Lith passes left to Williams. Back to Van Lith between the rings. Shot clock at 13. Guarded by Fulwiley around a screen. Pulls up from the foul line and buries it. Fading away to her left. And the lead is trimmed to 11 at 57-46. Heck of a shot by Van Lith. She's got 7 points. She was fading away to her left, taking that shot, and somehow knocked it down. 2:15 to play in the third. Lob it up top to Watkins at the free throw line. Tries to drive. Runner from the baseline won't go down. Rebound to Anissa Morrow and another foul on Ashlyn Watkins. And she just can't stay out of foul trouble. And that's going to send it the other way for two free throws. And again, you have got to be smarter and pick your spots. You cannot keep fouling 90 feet from the basket. Especially against a team who's killing it at the free throw line. Full Wiley out, gets a nice round of applause, and she exits with 20 points. Full Wiley's career high is 21. Shahina Pau-Pau back in, and again, it's Anissa Morrow at the line who's been automatic today. 15 points, she's 6-for-6 from the line and an 84% free throw shooter. Cannot keep doing this. This is what they did yesterday against Tennessee. Kept fouling and putting good shooters at the line. And Morrow hits the first one. And you especially can't foul 80 feet from the basket. Another one for Morrow. Gamecocks' lead was 13 a moment ago. It's 10 now. They'll try to cut it to single digits, and they do, as Morrow cuts it down to 9 at 57-48. Still perfect from the free throw line. 2 minutes to play in the third. Up top it comes to Watkins. Terminates the dribble, needs help. Hands it off to Tessa Johnson, right wing. Tessa, stop and go dribble. Spins, lost the handle, gets it back up top to Watkins. 10 to shoot it now for Pau-Pau, left side. On the dribble, pull up jumper, had her shot blocked by Flau J. Johnson from behind. Angel Reese with the rebound, and LSU has it on a run of their own. Flau J. right wing three, and she buries it, and just like that, the lead is down to 6. 57-51, and the Gamecocks seeing their big lead disappear again quickly. Pau-Pau, three ball, left it short, and nobody rebounding. That should have been a long rebound to the Gamecocks as it caromed out behind the three-point line and nobody got it. Here's Angel Reese. Has the ball knocked out of her hands and out of bounds. It'll stay with LSU. The lead was 13 moments ago. It's down to 6 on a 7-0 run with 1:19 to play in the third. And LSU will bring it in baseline left side. Gamecocks need to stop in a big way. Had all the momentum in the world but couldn't hold it. Just like yesterday. It's a good LSU team, obviously. Ranked 8th in the country. They lob it up top to Anissa Morrow. One-on-one with Kitts. Puts it on the floor, trying to drive. Floats it high off the glass and in. And it's a 9-0 run, and the wheels were coming off again for the Gamecocks. The lead down to 4, and this is very quick. It's been less than 2 minutes. They've scored 9 straight points as LSU. Down to a 4-point lead at 57-53. Here's Raven dribbling right. Back to her left with 13 to shoot it. Back door cut to Pau-Pau. She blows the layup. And LSU saves it. My goodness, you do everything right, but you miss the layup. 45 seconds to play, and the Gamecocks trying not to collapse again. Van Lith, you don't want to foul here and put him at the line. 36 seconds to play in the quarter, just a 4-point lead. Up top to Morrow. One-on-one with Kitts. Drives in the lane. Awkward shot won't go. Rebound to Reese. Her shot was blocked. Pau-Pau with the rebound, but then it's stolen away. Follow-up shot won't go down. Gamecocks get the rebound. And then we give it away. Shot in the paint by Morrow, no good. Gets her own rebound, and then Pau-Pau steals it away. 15 seconds to play in the quarter. Raven Johnson driving, spinning, shooting, scoring, and the Gamecocks lead 59-53. 5 seconds to play, and ball knocked away by Raven to keep Van Lith from setting up for a three-pointer with 2.4 seconds to play. Well, that snapped that 9-0 run. I thought Raven kind of rushed it, but she got it to go. Gamecocks lead is 6. It was 13 less than 3 minutes ago. Nikayla Williams will trigger it in with 2.4 seconds to play. Get it in. Morrow up top for 3. No good, and that's how the third quarter will end. 30 minutes in the books, 10 minutes to decide an SEC tournament champion. South Carolina leading LSU here 59-53. We'll take a timeout and come back with our final frame after this. It's Carolina basketball from Learfield. 7 innings due to the run rule. Gamecock baseball wins it 22-6 today. So congratulations to Gamecock baseball. Here, 10 minutes to decide who will be the SEC tournament champion. Gamecocks led by Malaysia Fulwiley with 20 points off the bench today. Tina Pau-Pau has 10. For the Tigers, Anissa Morrow has 19 to go along with 8 rebounds. She's also 8 for 8 from the foul line. Gamecocks struggled similar to what they did yesterday, continuing to foul and send their opponent to the free throw line. That's how Tennessee got back into the game yesterday, and that's how the Tigers were getting back into this thing in the third quarter after the Gamecocks were up 13. Back-to-back multiple fouls kept giving them chances, and to their credit, Morrow keeps knocking them down, keep fouling the wrong one. Tigers are 12 out of 16 from the stripe. Gamecocks are 10 out of 13. If the Gamecocks can find a way here in the fourth quarter. At stake, Gamecocks looking for their 8th SEC tournament championship in the last 10 years. LSU looking for their 3rd SEC tournament championship, but first since 2003. On the floor to start the fourth, Raven Johnson, Tessa Johnson, Tahina Pau-Pau, Ashlyn Watkins, Camilla Cardoso. It'll be LSU ball to start the fourth, moving left to right in their purple uniforms. Gamecocks in their home whites, and we're underway. Van Lith across the timeline, passes left to Morrow. She's guarded by Watkins, stabbing at the basketball. Trying to drive into the lane, put the shot up, blocked by Watkins. Raven with the rebound. Ashlyn Watkins gets another one. Second in the SEC in blocked shots. Gets a big one there. Carolina ball here, Raven Johnson setting the offense. Double high screen, dribbling to her right. Lobs it down low for Camilla. 1-1 with Reese. Yes, that is a foul on Angel Reese. She had Camilla Cardoso tied up. And Angel's pitching a fit, so is Kim Mulkey. But that was an easy one. And Reese has picked up only her third foul, non-shooting. They isolated Camilla with Angel, cleared everyone out, and tried that entry pass. Got to throw it higher to Camilla. They get it to her on the corner. Gets it back to Raven on the right wing. Guarded by Van Lith. Down to Camilla on the baseline, fighting through a double team. Off the window, too strong. Watkins with the rebound. Stick back won't go. Camilla with the rebound. Her stick back is good. And it's 61-53. Just the 6 point for Camilla. It's an 8 point lead for the Gamecocks. 9:13 to play in this one, 61-53, South Carolina. Working right side, Michaela Williams for LSU, guarded by Tessa Johnson. Around the screen, dumps it to Angel Reese on the right side of the block. Trying to drive, puts it up and in off the window. That was too easy. 61-55, got to deny those passes to Reese. She's got 9 points and 13 boards. 8:50 to play, the lead down to 6. Raven around a double screen to her right. Perhaps that isolation play again. Get it up top to Watkins. Watkins trying to drive, lost the handle. Pau-Pau picks it up with 10 to shoot it. Works it right wing to Raven. Underneath to Camilla. She beats Angel Reese and lays it in for 2 more. Back to an 8-point lead at 63-55. 8 points for Camilla. 8.5 minutes to play in this one. Work it left side to Flauje Johnson. Gets a screen from Angel Reese. Comes around it up top. Lost the handle, but picks it up before it can cross midcourt. Shot clock at 15. Flauje driving right side. Kick out in the corner. Michaela Williams for 3. Air ball. And Raven with the rebound on the other side. Gamecocks lead is 8 with 8 minutes to play. Watkins will bring it up. Being trailed by Morrow. Finally gives it up to Raven. Gamecocks will settle into the half court here. Raven guarded closely by Van Lith. Raven dribbling right around that double screen to Watkins up top. Watkins steps into a 15-footer. Yes! Ashlyn Watkins showing some range. It's a 10-point lead. 65-55 with 7:41 to play. First field goal for Watkins, just 3 points for her today. Up top, Flauzy drives into the lane. Pull-up jumper. Got it. Somehow over the outstretched arms of Camilla Cardoso, who did her job and stuck her arms straight up. It's a heck of a shot by Flauzy Johnson. Makes it 65-57. And a timeout taken by Kim Mulkey. We'll take a break as well. 7:29 to play. Still just an 8-point lead on the floor for Carolina. It is Breezy Hall, Ashlyn Watkins, Camilla Cardoso, Raven Johnson, and Tahina Pau-Pau. It'll be Carolina ball. Got to go the length of the floor, moving right to left. Got to keep this momentum going. Gamecocks have led by 13 a few times, but the Tigers keep finding a way to get within arm's reach. Still a ways to go in this one, especially how quickly LSU has cut the deficit earlier. Raven will bring it up. Here we go. Raven and Camilla with big smiles as they cross midcourt. They're always smiling. Raven dribbling to her right around the double screen. To the right wing, guarded by Van Lith. Trying to drive in the paint. To the top of the circle now on the drag dribble. Passes right. Pau-Pau on the dribble. Pau-Pau drives. Bounce and got it. Banks it in. Pau-Pau used the window in the square. Back to a 10-point lead at 67-57. A dozen points for Tahina Pau-Pau. 7 minutes to play in the contest. Here come the Tigers. Michaela Williams running point on this trip. Passes left to Van Lith. Started by Pau-Pau. Drives the baseline. Put the shot up and in. And again, Gamecocks allowing the Tigers to score too quickly. 67-59. The lead down to 8. Van Lith with 9 points. Gamecocks need a stop after they score and try to get that momentum back. Work at left side, Breezy Hall on the wing. Down low, Camilla working on Angel Reese. Drive, shoots, missed it, gets her own rebound. Stick back, rattles out, no good. Rebound LSU as Camilla misses twice from point blank range. Anissa Morrow driving into the lane. Hands it off to Michaela Williams. Back to Morrow right side. Feed it inside to Angel Reese. She'll muscle her way up. Shot blocked by Cardoso. Rebound to Flauzy Johnson. Zips it into the lane to Williams. Angel Reese on the baseline. 10 to shoot it. 6 minutes to play. Now Van Lith on the left wing, around a screen. She'll pop a three, got it. And just like that, the lead is trimmed 67-62. It was 13, it's down to 5 with 6:10 to play. Good offensive series there for LSU. Gamecocks struggling here with their consistency. But a big three by Haley Van Lith, her first of the game, gives her 11 points. And the senior, it's her 37th of the year. I'm going to review it to make sure it was a three, I suppose. Just a six. Was it a three or a two? They put two on the scoreboard. And we're going to see if it's a three. I thought it was a three initially. But Gamecocks, yeah, it will be a three. I believe that's the right call, 67-62. Gamecocks lead is 5, and again, how quickly LSU is able to cut this deficit is the tough part. Malaysia Fulwiley will check in for the Gamecocks. Gamecocks need a bucket. As again, the momentum keeps escaping quickly. Have to go the length of the floor. So it's Breezy Hall, Raven Johnson, Ashlyn Watkins, Malaysia Fulwiley, Camilla Cardoso on the floor. Raven will bring it up for Carolina. Raven across the SEC logo. Settle into a slow half-court set here. Raven around the screen to her right. Trying to drive against Van Lith. Lost the handle, had her pocket picked by Flauzy Johnson. And here we go. Flauzy driving against Fulwiley. Cut off in the corner. Delivers up top to Morrow. One-on-one with Watkins. Trying to create. Drives into the lane. Floats it up. No good. Rebound out to Fulwiley after a tip from Camilla. Fulwiley one-on-one with Van Lith, goes up, has her shot blocked by Van Lith, but she was out of bounds on the baseline when she got the rebound. It'll be Carolina ball. Heck of a defensive play by Van Lith. Lay wanted a foul, didn't get it. So it'll be Carolina ball. Lead is just 5 at 67-62, 5:28 to play, and a timeout taken by South Carolina. It's a 30, so we'll keep it right here. 5-point lead for the Gamecocks, just can't quite keep this offensive momentum. Fulwiley, Raven Johnson, Pau-Pau, Watkins, and Cardoso on the floor. Raven will trigger it in, baseline right side for the Gamecocks. Need a good set here. Lots of ebbs and flows in this game. Raven with Van Lith in front of her. Had Fulwiley wide open under the basket, couldn't get it to her. Instead, Pow Pow on the far side. Pow Pow on the right wing, trying to create to Watkins, driving in the lane. Pull-up jumper, left it short. Rebound to Van Lith, and the Gamecocks not very aggressive going after rebounds. Van Lith goes the other way, missed the layup in traffic, and Pow Pow gets the rebound. The Gamecocks have it. Outlet to Fulwiley, one on three. She likes the math, puts up a poor shot, and a rebound to LSU. That's a bad decision there. Here's Angel Reese the other way in transition. She'll get the layup, and it's 67-64. That was a terrible decision by Fulwiley. It was one on three, and she didn't even get a good look. And then you give up a layup on the other end, and just like that, the 13-point lead is down to three. Got to be smarter than that. 4:45 to play, just a three-point lead. It was 13 just moments ago. And now it's stolen away by Flaujay Johnson. She just took it away from Lay. Will race the length of the floor and get fouled, and will go to the line. My goodness. As good as Fulwiley has played, the last 60 seconds have not been her best basketball. A foolish decision on a one-on-three, and then just turned it over and committed a foul. Breezy Hall will come in for Pow Pow, a little surprised at that. And Flaujay Johnson will be at the line. She's got 11 points. 7-0 run by the Tigers here. And again, the Gamecocks seeing a big lead crumble here in the late going. Tigers continue to hit free throws well. Flaujay hits the first one. She can make it a one-point game with another make here. And she does, 67-66. 13-point lead is down to one with 4:35 to play. Now it's the Gamecock fans who are quiet. Purple and gold fans have something to cheer about. Up top, Breezy Hall. Gamecocks need a bucket. 9-0 run by the Tigers here. 15 to shoot it. Fulwiley trying to create, and she's got her pocket picked again. Able to recover. Gets it to Raven. Raven stops, pops, and banks it in for two. And the Gamecocks lead 69-66. Big shot for Raven. She's got nine. Had to have that after Fulwiley almost turned it over again. 4 minutes to play here in Greenville. Just a three-point lead after leading by 13 in this half. Van Lith around a screen to her left. Drives the baseline. Cut off there. Out to Angel Reese up top. She wants three. Left it short. Raven with the rebound, and the Gamecocks have it. Raven across the timeline. Keep an eye on Anissa Morrow and Ashlyn Watkins. They have really been going at it here. Here's Raven Johnson right side. Shot clock at 15. Up top, feed it underneath to Watkins. Find the drive, pull up jumper in the lane, left it short. Rebound lost out of bounds to the Gamecocks. 3:27 to play, just a three-point game. Three-point lead for the Gamecocks at 69-66. Gamecocks still being out-rebounded by nine here. Raven will bring it in baseline right side for Carolina. Got to hurry. Gets it into Breezy. Right wing three. Back rimmed it. No good. Rebound Watkins. Fresh set for the Gamecocks with 3:20 to play. Gamecocks in front by three. Raven on the left wing. Up top to Breezy. Breezy on the dribble around a screen to her right. Breezy drives. Puts it off the window for two. Breezy Hall makes it 71-66. She's got 7 points. 3:05 to play here in Greenville. Flaujay Johnson quickly down the floor, driving into the lane, floats it up, shot was blocked, Morrow with the rebound, follow-up no good, rebound knocked out of bounds by Camilla. Don't know why Camilla didn't just grab it, she kind of swatted at it. It'll stay with LSU. Just a five-point lead, LSU will retain possession, under 3 minutes to play. Camilla looked like she had a contact come out. May have gotten a finger in the eye. We want to get a sub in, but not in time. They get it in. Van Lith on the right wing. Guarded by Raven Johnson. Shot clock at 14. Around a screen from Reese. Another screen from Reese to her right. She'll pop a three. Left it short. Rebound Raven, and the Gamecocks have it. 2:40 to play. Gamecocks lead is five. Big possession here to see if the Gamecocks can make it a three-possession game. Looks like they'll try to work some clock and play catch up top. Cardoso, top of the circle, 15 to shoot it. She'll hand it to Breezy. Breezy around a screen to her left. Pull up from the left elbow. Got it! Breezy Hall with 9 points, and the Gamecocks lead 73-66. 2:14 to play. It's a 7-point lead. Here's Flaje Johnson. And a steal by Malaysia Fulwiley. That's got to be an intentional foul. Oh, my. Flaje Johnson just threw a punch at Ashlyn Watkins. And there's a melee in midcourt. Oh, my. This is getting out of hand. And they're going to have to do a whole lot of review in here. There was a punch thrown by Flaje Johnson after the intentional foul. My goodness. Dawn Staley furious, speaking with the officials. She'll have to go back to the bench. They will review all of this. There are going to be multiple fouls here. There was a response by a Gamecock, but it was initiated by Flaje, who had an intentional foul after wrapping up the South Carolina player. And then there was a punch thrown. Looks like Camilla Cardoso has a bloody lip. This may take a while to sort out. 2:08 to play. Gamecocks lead 73-66 over LSU here in the SEC Tournament Championship. Camilla getting looked at for a bloody lip. The initial play was a steal by Malaysia Fulwiley from Flaje Johnson. Then Flaje wrapped her up. It was obviously an intentional foul. Ashlyn Watkins said something to her. Flaje threw a punch. Camilla came in, gave a push to Flaje, and then a push by Van Lith. So you're going to see multiple fouls here on Flaje, Camilla, perhaps Van Lith. The initial shove was from Flaje to Ashlyn Watkins after Ashlyn Watkins had something to say to her. And then Camilla came in and gave a push. We're going to have a whole lot to sort out. While they do this, we'll try to sort through it ourselves. Getting a look. Fortunately, we do have a replay monitor here. This will be multiple fouls and multiple players. So we may have a whole lot of free throws coming up here, which right now favors LSU the way they shoot free throws. Three officials still at the scorer's table. Camilla's probably going to get a big foul as well, as she retaliated. They may get a fan ejected as well, as a fan came over the barricade from the stands behind the scorer's table. But there's no call for that. 2:08 to play here, and this is going to take a moment to sort out. They've called security behind the scorer's table, I think, for the fan who climbed over the scorer's table. But there will be multiple fouls on LSU and South Carolina, as there were different players that retaliated. You had the initial intentional foul on Flaje, who threw an initial shove. Camilla responded, which was bad on her part. So you're going to have a whole lot to sort through here. They're still sorting it out at the scorer's table, and Cardoso still dealing with a bloody lip. Now they're going over to the scorer's table at least to report it, and we'll see if we can catch it. Two of the officials still looking at replays here. It's going to be multiple players from both teams that are going to be tied up. The big issue is going to be how many free throws are taken and how many are made, because as it stands, it's a 7-point lead for the Gamecocks, and you'd hate to see this game get closer because they make free throws. 2:08 to play in the fourth quarter, and things have boiled over here. Yeah, they've had to get the officials have gotten a pen and a piece of paper to write it all down. They're still over there reviewing. And again, there is definitely going to be at least one fan ejected here who climbed over the wall behind the scorer's table. Didn't make the floor, fortunately. But he's going to have to go if he's not out already. I don't care what school you're representing. You can't do that. There was a lot of jawing back and forth throughout this game, in particular between Anissa Morrow of LSU and Ashlyn Watkins of the Gamecocks. Now you need cooler heads to prevail. Watkins kind of poked the bear after the intentional foul was going to be called on Flauje Johnson. She let Flauje know about it, and Flauje reacted with a shove, and then Camilla came in with a shove of her own. And we had a near Pier 6 brawl. Looked like a little Donnybrook there as both benches cleared. That would be something else they have to check is who came off the bench. You can't come off the bench onto the floor. A lot of it happened in the non-playing area. So with 2:08 to go, we might see some ejections here. Because if you leave the bench and come onto the playing floor, that would be an issue as well. They are going to have a ton to sort out, which could have a huge impact on this game. Gamecocks currently on a 6-0 run after the Tigers had cut it to 7. Again, it all started with a steal by Malaysia Fulwiley, the intentional foul at half court by Flauje Johnson, a little taunt by Watkins, and then a shove by Flauje, and then a big shove by Camilla. So Flauje and Camilla could get the worst of this. I didn't see any South Carolina players from the bench that made it onto the floor itself. Now the Gamecock fans starting to get loud. Crowds from both teams just getting loud here as they're still trying to sort this thing out. They've got pen and paper over there. They've got a long list to out here, but this could directly affect the outcome of the game. There were coaches from both teams that came to try to break it up. And again, there was a couple of fans that climbed over the wall behind the scorer's table. That's even scarier. And if they're not already ejected, I'm sure they will be. Well, they do play minor league hockey here, and it looked like a hockey game broke out. 2:08 to play, and they're still sorting it out at the scorers table, with South Carolina leading it 73-66. I tell you what, we'll go ahead and try to take a quick timeout here and be back in just a moment. It's Carolina basketball from Learfield. And we welcome you back to Greenville, South Carolina, in front of LSU 73-66 with 2:08 to play in the fourth quarter. And they're still at the scores table trying to figure out this little Donnybrook we had here that cleared both benches. And we're waiting for the officials to discuss who's going to be left, because there could be some ejections from people who left the bench. We'll wait and see. But they've been at the scorer's table for about 10 minutes now. And we'll see if we get an announcement. I don't know if we're going to get an announcement. The officials finally away from the scorer's table. It all started with a steal from Malaysia Fulwiley and an intentional foul on Floje Johnson. And Floje shoved Ashlyn Watkins. And then Camilla Cardoso shoved Floje Johnson. And then the bench is cleared. And the officials now on the court discussing what should happen, but we've had no announcement. They spent about 10 minutes looking at the monitor to figure out who's gone, who gets a foul, how many free throws we're going to shoot, but this is taking quite a long time. Gamecock baseball a winner today, knocking off Longwood 22-6 to sweep the three-game series there. Gamecock softball falls at Texas A&M today in another 2-1 game. They lost back-to-back games 2-1 to the nationally ranked Aggies and get swept in that three-game SEC series opener. Elsewhere in women's college tournaments, ACC Tournament Championship, Notre Dame defeats NC State in the title game today, 55-51. Iowa wins the Big Ten Tournament over Nebraska, 94-89. SEC Tournament, the Big 12 semifinals will be tomorrow. Oklahoma against Iowa State and Texas against Kansas State. Pac-12 Tournament Championship tonight will have second-ranked Stanford against fifth-ranked Southern Cal. And here, the officials still trying to sort out the laundry list of possible fouls, ejections, what have you. And we'll see if we can pick it up. And again, they won't come over and tell radio. We're on the opposite side of the scorer's table, unfortunately, so we can't hear what the officials are talking about. They will come over and tell TV. So we won't have a clear indication unless they tell us on the PA system. And if they do that, we'll try to pull up the crowd mic and see if we can pick it up along with them. But this is about a 15-minute delay at this point in the stretch of this game with the game still in the balance. Gamecocks leading by 7 with 2:08 to play. Now the official's back at the scorer's table talking with the alternate official who's got a pen and paper out. My goodness. Both teams on their respective benches. Carolina coaching staff huddled together to figure out what they can do, but you don't know if you're going to lose any players. And there's still security behind the scorer's table. I'm sure there had to be at least two fans ejected, maybe more. And still waiting for an announcement from the officials about what they've seen here. This has taken a little bit longer than you might expect to get this sorted out. They've had the benefit of the replay. They've got a piece of paper out. It looks like they got a lot of names on it. So a lot of folks may be staying after school today, sitting in detention, the sin bin. Three officials away from the DV Sport Monitor now to discuss what the ramifications are going to be in terms of possible free throws and who can't play anymore. One official going to the official scorer, I guess, to log the fouls. And again, we won't really see that. Going to have to hope there's a articulate PA announcement. Or we'll just track it as it goes if there's a bunch of free throws and if there's folks that are sent to the locker room. The first call was the intentional foul on Floje Johnson. We don't have the TV audio to see what the official is telling the scorer's table on the laundry list of other fouls. And hopefully the PA announcer will follow through and let us know. 2:08 to go. Gamecocks with a 7-point lead, but how many players are each team going to lose on this? Still a long discussion with the official book to put fouls into the book. And this could directly impact the outcome of this game. Again, it all started with the steal by Malaysia Fulwiley of Floje Johnson. Flaugier, the intentional foul. A little bit of a taunt by Watkins, a shove of Watkins by Flaugier, then a shove of Flaugier by Cardoso. Now the officials coming away from the scorer's table. They're going to talk to Coach Don Staley first. I don't think either coach is going to be happy with what they hear. Still no announcement about fouls and ejections. Haven't seen anything like this in a long time. I hate to see it. It got ugly. But tensions were running high in this game with a lot of the jawing back and forth. And it led to physical violence, and you don't want to see that. And this has taken about 20 minutes to sort this out. Don Staley getting an explanation from two of the officials. And Kim Mulkey waiting her turn, I believe. But still no announcement. Angelica Suffren and Polani Spurlock-Welsh, the two female officials, talking with Coach Don Staley. And you can sense the antsiness from the fan base here. Now they'll go over and tell Kim Mulkey the details. Coach Mulkey wearing a glittery light blue sparkly jacket with some kind of dead animal on the sleeves by the cuffs. All right, so the Gamecocks huddled in front of their bench to let everyone know what's happening. But still no formal announcement to see who's in, who's out. They've told TV, and they're able to report that, but we don't have access to that because they haven't made a PA announcement. Long explanation going on to Kim Mulkey now. .208 to play, and the Gamecocks' lead is 7, but who knows what's going to happen now. Who's in, who's out? How many free throws are there going to be? You had the intentional foul on Flaugier Johnson. That was the only thing that was logged so far. Now they finished their conversation with Coach Mulkey. Now back to the scorer's table. I think this is progress. I'm not sure. Both teams doing their cheers, respective cheers. And it's going to get loud in here until we start playing again. They're still sorting it out at the scorer's table. Not sure why this is taking this long. We'll see if we can get a clarification here on what the deal is. See with some of our fellow media mates, you got any explanation of what's going on? Whoa. Okay. So the LSU players that are not in the game have gone to their locker room. Let's see.
Intentional foul called on LSU number 4, Flaugier Johnson.
Intentional foul on Flaugier Johnson. Then a intentional foul on Camilla.
Came to the court. All players ejected from both teams except for South Carolina number 20, Sanaya Fagan. She will replace 10, Camilla Cardoso.
Okay.
For South Carolina, Tahina Pompeo also still in the game.
So all players not in the game have been ejected for both teams. So you got to finish with what you got. Oh, my. So that all the remaining Gamecocks have to go to the floor or to the bench. The only bench player for the Gamecocks not ejected is Tahina Pow-Pow. So the Gamecocks will have 6. And I think LSU will have just 5 to finish here. So the 5 on the floor for the Gamecocks are Ashlyn Watkins, Malaysia Fulwiley, Breezy Hall, Raven Johnson, and Snaya Fagan. And Pow-Pow is the lone sub. And I believe LSU will not have any subs. They say that people from the bench for both teams left, so they sent everybody to the locker room. Never seen this before. And so Malaysia Fulwiley will shoot the initial intentional fouls, and now you just don't want anything else, because there's going to be a quick whistle on anything else. You can believe it. So here's Lay at the line. First time at the line today. After sitting for about 20 minutes, she'll hit the first one. So they get 74-66, and Fulwiley has tied her season high with 21 points. One more time for Lay. Got them both, and it's a 9-point lead with 2:08 to play. Now LSU will go the other way and shoot their intentional fouls. It'll be Van Lith to shoot for the foul that was called on Cardoso. Van Lith with a dozen points, an excellent free throw shooter, and she hits the first one, an 82% free throw shooter. And you don't want to get into a free throw war with this team. They hit them both, so it's basically a wash. 75-68, Gamecocks with a 7-point lead with 2:08 to play. LSU ball moving left to right to try to cut into it. So Gamecocks would have had the possession after the intentional foul, but because we retaliated, it gives it to LSU. Angel Reese drives in the lane, floats it up and in, and just like that, the lead down to 5. It's 75-70 with 1:50 to play in the contest. Gamecocks need a bucket here. Got to work some clock, too. Raven guarded by Van Lith. Shot clock at 15 for Raven. Still has it on the floor. Tight man-to-man coverage. 10 seconds to shoot it. Gives it up to Breezy. Breezy takes a long three left wing. Off the rim, no good. Rebound to Anissa Morrow. Then we try to tie it up. And the Tigers come out of there with it. Not the possession we needed. Here come the Tigers. Michaela Williams drives in the lane, floats it up off the glass, no good. Rebound Watkins. It's going to be tied up. Held ball. Possession two, South Carolina with 1:15 to play. Gamecocks lead is 5. Got to work some clock and get some points here. We'll get Tahina Pau-Pau, the only sub left. They'll pick up Fulwiley, who's got a career-high 22 points tonight. 1:15 to play. Both teams have 2 fouls to give here. Raven will bring it up, guarded in the backcourt closely by Van Lith. 1:08 to play, a 5-point lead here in the SEC Tournament Championship. Raven on the right wing to Watkins in the far corner. Guarded by Morrow, had it knocked out of her hands, out of bounds. It'll remain with South Carolina. Crazy finish as both teams' bench players have all been sent to the locker room after the melee. We look to trigger it in with Pau-Pau on the far side. Gets it into Watkins. We're underway. 1 minute to play. The handoff to Raven. Gamecocks need a bucket here. 10 to shoot it, and a foul on Haley Van Lith. Non-shooting, however. Just her second and the team's 4th. The last to give before the bonus with 55 seconds to play. Got an inbound once again on the far side. Raven Johnson to do the honors. Gets it into Breezy up top. Here we go. Breezy bumped once, hands it off to Raven. Guarded closely by Van Lith. Got to do something with it. Got to come back to the basketball. Puts it on the floor. 9 seconds to shoot it for Raven. Raven, 5 seconds to shoot. Almost lost it. 3 seconds to shoot. Drives, shoots, doesn't score. Rebound to Fagan, and she's knocked to the floor. It'll be a foul on Angel Reese. Reese will pick up her 4th. That's the 5th team foul. With less than a second on the shot clock. When the Gamecocks will be at the line to try to extend the lead. It'll be Sanaya Fagan, who has not been good at the line this season, and not today. She's 0-for-2 from the line. Only 67% on the year. 35.7 seconds to go. We'll get Fulwiley in for Pau-Pau. Big free throws here for Sanaya Fagan, the junior. Just a 5-point lead. Makes the first one to make it 76-70. One more time. Fagan accepts the basketball. It's a 6-point lead with 35.7 seconds to go. Got them both. And it's a three-possession game at 77-70, and LSU will burn a timeout. And Tahina Pau-Pau coming off the bench to tell her teammates, pointing at her temple, saying, let's keep our heads here. You do not want to allow the Tigers to score with the clock not moving, so you don't want to foul. Both teams have been killing it at the free throw line today. LSU 16 out of 20, Gamecocks 14 out of 17. LSU is over the limit with five fouls. Gamecocks have only committed three, so they got one foul to give. LSU with one timeout remaining, the Gamecocks have three. It's a seven-point lead with 35.7 seconds to play. On the floor for Carolina, it's Fagan, Hall, Watkins, Fulwiley, and Raven Johnson. LSU will trigger it in the forecourt after the timeout in front of their own bench. Michaela Williams to trigger it in. Gets it into Angel Reese. Lob it to Van Lith, right side for three. Off the rim, no good. Breezy Hall with the rebound, and the Gamecocks have it, and she's fouled by Haley Van Lith. Or did we call a timeout? Let's see. Is it a foul or a timeout? 28.3 seconds to go. And they're going to rule a timeout, not a foul. Okay. So it'll be South Carolina ball. Gamecocks have two timeouts remaining. We were going to get the foul. So here we go. Gamecocks will take the timeout and set it up. 28.3 seconds to go. It's a seven-point lead for South Carolina, trying to win their eighth SEC tournament title in the last 10 years. And second in a row. Gamecocks have two timeouts remaining. LSU has one. Gamecocks just need to inbound and not turn it over. They will inbound in the backcourt. Raven Johnson on the near sideline. Off to our right, Kim Mulkey's got to get off the floor. We get it into Ashlyn Watkins. Watkins puts it on the floor as two Tigers run into each other. She'll get it across. 1 second differential between the game clock and the shot clock. Tigers got a foul, but they're not doing it. Raven Johnson up top. Clock ticking down. 15 seconds to play. And a timeout taken by Coach Staley, as Raven didn't want to get a five count. She didn't realize that she's got to advance the basketball. She was closely guarded. She was about a second away from doing that. So now each team has one timeout remaining, but I am shocked. LSU seems to have thrown in the towel. They didn't try to foul. 15.1 seconds to play. That was shocking. Gamecocks with a seven-point lead. They just need to inbound, take care of the basketball, and they'll lock up the SEC Tournament Championship. Got a little ugly here with some fisticuffs that sent both teams' benches to the respective locker rooms. Gamecocks will send a few players into the backcourt. Raven Johnson will trigger it in the forecourt. Just to our right. Raven looking. Gets it into Malaysia Fulwiley. Clock ticking down. Now they foul as Flo-Jay Johnson fouls Lay, and Flo-Jay says, hey, I didn't mean to hit you so hard. So 13 seconds to go. Malaysia Fulwiley already a career high, 22 points tonight. That's the last foul to give. No, though, the Tigers are over the limit. So Lay will be at the line to try to build on her career high. Gamecock fans on their feet. They can smell it. First free throw from Lay is good, and the Gamecocks lead 78-70. They're on their way to cutting down the nets again. One more time for Lay. Got them both, 79-70. Gamecocks, and LSU will burn its final timeout. We'll keep it right here. 13.2 seconds to play. Coach Kim Mulkey is going to try to draw up a nine-point play, apparently. Gamecocks, what's left of them, are celebrating on the bench. Again, everyone else had to go back to the locker rooms and watch this one on TV. Gamecocks, 13.2 seconds away from their eighth SEC tournament championship in the last 10 years. And will stay unbeaten at 32-0, while LSU will drop to 28-5. And it'll be the 16th straight win for South Carolina over LSU. That's hard to believe. Including a terrific regular season win, 76-70. This one's similar. It's 79-70 with 13.2 seconds to play. Tigers are out of timeouts. Gamecocks have one remaining, but it doesn't matter at this point. Just don't foul. If they're going to score, let them score, but don't let the clock stop. That's the key. On the floor for the Gamecocks, Breezy Hall, Malaysia Fulwiley, Sanaya Fagan, Ashlyn Watkins. Tigers will inbound in front of their bench across the way. Michaela Williams to do the honors. Don't want to foul, obviously, and put him at the line. Michaela Williams to trigger it in. Fulwiley in front of her. Lobs it underneath to Angel Reese. She's got it. We tie it up. Fagan will tie it up. Held ball. Possession will remain with LSU, but a good defensive play there. It took 2 seconds off the clock. One more time for the Tigers. They'll bring it in baseline right side. 11.3 seconds to play. Gamecocks lead is 9. Van Lith delivers up top to Angel Reese. Drives into the lane, floats it up and in, and it makes it 79-72. Trigger it into Raven, and she can dribble out the clock. That'll do it. A decade of dominance for South Carolina as they win their 8th SEC tournament title in 10 years. They knock off LSU 79-72, and the Gamecocks will cut down the nets once again. The Gamecocks are SEC tournament champions. They knock off the 8th-ranked LSU Tigers for the 16th consecutive time. We'll take a timeout and start our wrap-up after this. It's Carolina basketball from Learfield. Back in Greenville, Gamecocks are SEC tournament champions for the 8th time in 10 seasons. They knock off the LSU Tigers here in the title game, 79-72. Welcome into the post-game locker room report, driven by Jim Hudson Automotive. Don't know if we'll get one of our coaches here as they're putting the stage together out at center court, where they will have the official trophy presentation, and then South Carolina will cut down the nets here. Coach Dawn Staley doing her obligatory post-game television interview. Gamecocks improved to 32-0. LSU drops to 28-5 as they await NCAA tournament information a week from tonight. Let's run through the final numbers in the contest. LSU shot 43% from the floor, 28 out of 65. Hit 7 out of 20 from distance for 35%. They were killing it from the foul line, 16 out of 19 for 84. I'm sorry, this is South Carolina. 28 out of 65 for 43.1%. 7 out of 20 from three-point range. 16 out of 19 for 84% for the Gamecocks. Well above their season average. For LSU, shot 37% from the floor, 25 out of 67. They hit 6 out of 14 from distance. They were killing it from the free throw line as well, 16 out of 20 for 80%. The Tigers out-rebounded the Gamecocks 44 to 37, but the Gamecocks cut that deficit a little bit after trailing by double digits in that category. Leading scores, first for LSU, Anissa Morrow with 19 points and 10 rebounds to lead them as she posts yet another double-double, her 20th of the season. Flaugia Johnson had Angel Reese rather had 15 points, 13 rebounds for another double-double for her, her 22nd of the year. Haley Van Lith with 14, Flaugia Johnson with 13, 2 points for Michaela Williams, 6 for Aaliyah Delisario, and 3 for Janae Kent to round out their scoring. For the Gamecocks, just 2 in double figures, a little bit odd for this crew, but Malaysia Fulwiley, the freshman, a career-high 24 points here in the championship game. It was 12 points for Tahina Pau-Pau, 9 points for Breezy Hall, 9 for Raven Johnson, who also had 5 assists, 8 points for Camilla Cardoso to go along with 6 rebounds, 6 points for Chloe Kitts, 4 points for Sanaya Fagan, 4 points for Tessa Johnson, 3 for Ashlyn Watkins to round out South Carolina's scoring as they win it 79 to 72. And they continue to construct the stage here, and we'll get the Gamecocks up there for the trophy presentations. We continue with the post-game locker room report driven by Jim Hudson Automotive.